Last week it was the Lion's turn to be revealed on The Masked Singer, and while many fans at home guessed it was a lady with the best roar in the business, not one member of the panel knew who it was. What a voice, what a woman. Please welcome to Studio 10, the one, the only, Kate Ceberano.
Good morning, hi.
So great to see you, Kate. Osher admitted that you were his childhood crush. Jackie O said that she listens to you singing your music on the way to work every morning. Were you surprised that given you have such a distinctive voice, the panel couldn't actually guess who you were?
Well, in the first couple of shows, I did try to camouflage it. And I just thought, well, I'd watched the show before. I'd watched the Korean show and I'd watched the show in America. And I thought the only way you're going to hang in there, since it's an identity competition, is to try to camouflage who you are, at least just to begin with, you know.
How did you do that?
Well, I selected songs off my daughter's playlist, so I thought, well, this is music like no one would expect me to sing. And then I also sort of lowered my register and made myself sound a little bit like the sort of tranny version of myself. Which was kind of fun. And then I suppose after a little while, you know, there was my true self that would ring out in the bridge. Like, I've got a certain sound when I hit high notes.
Yeah, you do.
And people started to kind of hear that and they were going, oh, I reckon that's Kate. I think that's Kate. But for the panel, I think in the room it's so busy in there and so noisy, I don't know what they were hearing. It may have been a little bit confusing.
Oh, but beautiful. I guess, Kate, Kerri-Anne here, you must...
Oh, hi, darling.
Hi.
Hi.
Bit disappointed not to make that big finale?
Oh, no. I was quite happy to go home when I went home. It was... I thought that... Just for the sake of the show and for the point that I wanted to experience for myself and for home viewers, we've sort of lost a lot of television that's like Countdown and, you know, real family sort of shows where families can sit in together and experience music and listen to great singers and, you know, really have that, sort of wholesome kind of vibe. There's a lot of stuff on television that you wouldn't share with your kids.
Yeah.
And I thought it was wonderful and I was in for just exactly as long as I wanted to be there and... in the same week, I won an ARIA award for a jazz album.
Amazing.
All these other... And so it's not like I'm in any... I didn't need it for any confidence reasons to have to hang in. It wasn't really a singing competition, but more just about wearing a fantastic outfit and having fun.
Kate, I have to say, I'm disappointed you left so easily. The Kate Ceberano I know would have said, I won't ever walk away, I'll just be brave and stay.
Oh, listen, it was brave enough just to hang in there with a 5-kilo head.
Yeah.
And, short of getting skeletal damage, my knees are still bone.
I was actually just thinking, because what you were saying before made me think, it's like this double-edged sword, because you've got to try to disguise your voice so people can't guess who you are, but your voice, of course, is the thing that makes you and is the most extraordinary thing about you, which is what you need for people to keep you in the competition. So you're kind of against type. And then you have to hide the whole thing from your family. Did you keep this a secret from your daughter?
Oh, yeah, we wanted to keep it. I mean, my next-door neighbours were certain it was me and I was like, can I have some sugar, please? Then we just moved on. But the thing, I think the thing with being on the show, like I said, I don't actually think of it as a competition. I mean, the kids at home, in many ways, they don't know who I am. The younger generation don't know who I am. And so for them, picking me is hard. It's not like, I mean, anyone of the... 30 years and above may know my voice and have grown up with it. But for kids, they're just kind of getting to meet me. And I loved that.
I think it's great. I'm with you. Being able to sit down with my daughter and watch this on the telly has just been incredible and always love seeing you on the telly, gorgeous Kate. Hey, tell us what else is going on in your world apart from scooping up more arias. You must have a mantelpiece the size of the coast of Eastern Australia.
Oh, I'm very proud of everything that I've been allowed to get away with in Australia. Being an artist in this country has afforded me the luxury of being able to be everything. I've got a single on the radio with Steve Kilby from the Church, which I wrote, an ARIA award for a jazz album, singing with symphony orchestras, and then doing The Masked Singer. So, I mean, really, only in this country could you be allowed to do all of that and you know, still be singing in your 50s. I mean, yeah. I'm pretty grateful.
You know, you took it to another level, Kate, and you became the director of the Arts Festival down in Adelaide. That was also very, very giving.
I think if you want to stay around in the business, it's best to give your friends jobs.
Well, you did
you
ask
can't
me
scoop
and
up
I
all
said
the...
no.
Oh, yeah, I know. You can't scoop up all the awards, you know, and not build a bridge and have a sort of... and allow people to kind of climb across and have the kind of experiences you've had. So I do take my job as a mentor and as a kind of peer for others very seriously. And again, just on The Masked Singer, I truly don't know who is on the show for tonight's show. I don't know who has won the show. I don't know who were involved during the time I was on the show. And so I'll be just as much an audience as you guys will be tonight.
Yeah, well, is it going to be the wolf, the monster or the robot? You can find out tonight when The Masked Singer finale airs, 7:30 p.m. on 10 and Win. Kate Ceberano, you're an absolute legend. Thank you for joining us.
See ya.